Hello there. I am going to review the problem-solving process with you and how to type in your answer to a problem-solving prompt online. This is just an example problem. This is not the problem that has been assigned to you. We have here splitting can be example. If you look up here at my title, I have titled my document 00, or I would put my classroom number, period, name, period, and the title of the document, splitting candy example. In your case, it'll probably be splitting candy 1 or 2, whichever worksheet you're on. Don't forget, you're going to have to make a copy for yourself. You can't use the one that gets linked to straight off the website. Okay, also, don't forget to share your document with your teacher. Make sure that it's shared with them when you click on the shared section here. If it's not shared with them, make sure to type their email address in, their Kipapa email address, and make sure they can edit, then click Done. Okay, let's begin with the problem. We have here, Janie has 4 students that she wants to buy candy for. She buys 8 different bags of candy. Each bag has 20 pieces of candy in it. If Janie and her students split up all of the candy equally, how many pieces of candy will each person get? We're going to start off by underlining the question. You highlight the question, click the underline button, and it's underlined now. The next thing we're going to do is find the important information. In order to figure this problem out, I need to know how many pieces of candy Janie actually has. I'm going to figure that out by looking at the amount of bags that she bought. I'm going to highlight that and make that bold. I'm also going to have to figure out how many pieces are in each bag. We have here each bag has 20 pieces. So I'm going to highlight that and make that bold. Okay, I'm ready for step one. I'm going to click into the work area, write step one and a colon, and then I'm going to figure out how many bags Janie has. That's going to be 20 times 8. So I can do it like this. I'm going to hit tab. I'm going to type 20. I'm going to push enter. Hit tab again twice. Then I'm going to put times 8. I'll go ahead and underline that. Makes that a little easier to see. Okay, I can go ahead and put a space between the X and the 8 and maybe move this 20 over. All right. Hit tab twice. Hit space bar a few times. Okay, now here we go. 8 times 0 is 0. 8 times 2 is 16. So I just have to line my answer up, and there we go. That's my answer for step one. Let's make that look nice. Oh, let's go ahead and label the numbers. So we have 20 pieces, 8 bags, and 160 pieces of candy. That is not the end of the problem, though, because it's asking how many pieces of candy each person will get. So I have to move on to step two. Step two. Okay, now I know that it says here Janie and her students are gonna split up the candy. So there's Janie is one person, she has 4 students. 1 plus 4 is 5. So one Janie plus 4 students equals 5 people. Okay, that's good. Let's move on to step three. Well, not really three, it's more like 2.5. It's still kind of the same step. We'll just make it step two. Okay, let's continue on. Because there are 160 pieces of candy being shared amongst 5 people, we're going to divide 160 into 5. Or by 5. So we'll write 160. There's a division sign up here. I'm going to highlight it. I'm going to copy it. And down here, I am going to paste it. There we go. 160 divided by 5 equals. All right. Now, from here, you can go ahead and use the break apart strategy. So let's go ahead and label these numbers first. And then we'll use the break apart strategy. In the break apart strategy, you're going to keep one number the same, which is usually the smaller number, or the second number, I should say, and you're going to break up the first number. Okay, so we're going to do it that way. We have 160 divided by 5. So 160, how can we break that up? Well, we can break that up into 100 and 60, because 100 plus 60 equals 160. And then we can go ahead and divide each by 5. All right, I know that if I count by 5s 20 times, I will get 100. That means that 20 times 5 is 100, which must mean that 100 divided by 5 is 20. Okay, now, when it comes to 60, if I count by 5s 12 times, I would get 60. So, if 12 times 5 is 60, that means that 60 divided by 5 is 12. Okay, now that I have these two numbers here, what I can do is add them together. I'm going to put a little plus next to the 12. I'll move the 20 over a little bit there. Go ahead and underline this. I just have to add them together. I'll hit the tab button to move my cursor up and the space bar. Okay, 0 plus 2 is 2. 2 plus 1 is 3. And we get 32. That means that 160 divided by 5 must be equal to 32. So I am going to write here 32 pieces of candy. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and take a look at the rubric here. It says used an appropriate strategy. Oh, let's go ahead and make this middle aligned. There we go. Yes, I did. I'll put an X there. Did I get the correct answer? I believe so. Did I label my answer? Yes, I did. Restated the answer in a complete sentence. No, I did not. So I'm going to click into the answer bar here and I'm going to write a complete statement or a complete sentence. If Janie and her students split up the candy equally, comma, each person will get 32 pieces of candy, period. Okay, there we go. I have my sentence and a second strategy to check my work. Okay. Well, let's go ahead and take a look at step one. We need to find a way to check our work. So I'm gonna stick my cursor right here between step one and step two, put a little bit of space, and I'm gonna say step one checking. Put a colon there. Okay. Now, the opposite of multiplication is division, so I could check that way. I could also use the break apart strategy for this too. Let's see, we have 20 pieces, so that would be 20 times 8. And now, if I broke the 20 up, I could break the 20 up into 10 and 10. Okay, so I would have 10 times 8. In this case, when you're doing the break apart strategy for multiplication, you do not break up both numbers. Break up the first one or break up the second one. I would recommend you break up the bigger one. Okay, so 10 times 8 is 80. 10 times 8 is 80. Let's make sure that we add them together correctly. I'm gonna put the plus sign there, put that little underline there, and 80 plus 80 is 160. Okay, so I have checked my work for step one. Okay, step two. Let's go ahead and check our work there. Five people minus four students equals one person, and that one person is Janie. So we are good on this equation. Okay, all we have to do is try this in a different way. So we'll put step two, checking. All I have to do is break up 160 into two different numbers that still equal 160. I know that 160 can be broken in half, and you would have 80 and 80. 80 plus 80 is equal to 160. So I could do that. I could say 80 divided by 5. And then I could do that again here. I'll just copy and paste it. All right then. So 80 divided by 5. If I was to count by 5s, let's see, I would have a 1 in the tens column and a 6 in the ones column, 16. Same thing there. All I have to do is add up these two numbers. Set that up. Okay, and 16 plus 16 is 32. I would get the exact same answer. So that means I am correct on step two. All right, I can come down to the rubric again, or this checklist. I can go ahead and put an X there. I've used the second strategy for every single one of my calculations. And finally, grade. Let's see. For an A, if you meet all three P criterias, let's look at those. Use an efficient strategy, yes. Has the correct answer, yes. Labels the answer correctly, yes. So we have all that. Restates the answer in a complete sentence, we did. And uses a second strategy to check your work. Yes, there is a second strategy for each equation here. Okay, so that means that this would be worth an A. So under grade, I'll go ahead and put an A. Now this section here needs to be left blank because your teacher is going to fill that section out. Your teacher right there. Okay, once you are done, make sure that you just let your teacher know that you're done. You can highlight the title, insert a comment, and just say, I am finished. And this is ready to grade. Period. Leave the comment there, and you should be done. From there, you could just close the tab. Okay, I hope this video helps, and I wish you all well on figuring out these different problems that will be given to you this week.